I'm John Notaft. I recently authored Old McCandle in His Musical Farm with fantastic illustrations by Dr. Bienvenido Castillo. During this pandemic, I thought this would be some great entertainment for all of you at home. So this book was dedicated to my niece, Rosalind, and who I hope inspires a lifetime filled with the joy of music. Old McCandle loved two things: his farm and his music. During the day, he would take care of his friends, the animals on his farm. At night, he would work on composing a piece for his ensemble of friends to play together. Robert and Clara Sheepman were expecting their first little lamb. McCandle decided to write a composition for the celebration of their new addition. The piece was coming along well, but McCandle was struggling with an ending. Bela Bardog and Benjamin Kitten, his closest companions, advised McCandle to take a walk and get some fresh air. "Let us go feed our flocks," they suggested. "A great idea will soon come forth." So I'd like to introduce my mom, publisher, and fantastic singer, who will be singing a piece from Handel's Messiah. McCandle was feeding Dmitri Shostak goldfish, looking for inspiration, when Felix Mendelssohn and Gustav Mahler came swimming by. McCandle told them of his quandary. They advised, "The ending should be exultant and full of majesty. Always end on a high note." McCandle thought that was a good idea. Music for a baby's birth should be glorious. So here's a little bit of water music for you to enjoy. Johann Sebastian Quack and his ducklings, Wilhelm Friedemann, Carl Philipp, and Johann Christian waddled by and offered a counterpoint. Johann Sebastian enjoyed musical motifs that repeat, a fugue, make it a fugue. Johann Christian echoed, a fugue, make it a fugue. Wilhelm Friedemann quacked with a primary theme to set the mood. Carl Philipp added, and a counter-subject interlude. The farmer assured them that a fugue was already featured in the work. Here's the fugue he was talking about. McCandle decided to head over to his barnyard. He told Peter Ilyich Tchaikovsky and Claude Debussy about his creative block. Make it rich. Milk the ending. Give it all you got. The sheep, Samuel Barber and Johannes Brahms, suggested that the song should be easy to count. Sheep can count to 100 in their sleep, but many humans cannot. Keep it simple so people will enjoy it too. This is what they thought the piece should sound like. Olivier Messiaen, Frédéric Chopin, Josquin, and Ludwig van Beethoven were happy birds. They roamed cage-free. They clucked, "Let it be from the heart, an ode to parental joys." Niccolo Paganini was rolling in the mud with his violin when McCandle came by. Paganini agreed with his friends. It should be grand, brilliant, and spirited, but most importantly, virtuosic. Hello. Next page. It was time to go collect the honey from the combs. Georges Bumblebizet was storing nectar for the queen bee Carmen. William Hummingbird was also pollinating when old McCandle came upon the two. George and William had a very different suggestions for the ending. George wanted to be risque, but William overruled. Solomon Sacred would do. The bears came to the beehive to have their lunch. Leonard Bernstein and Hector Berlioz were fixated on the idea of honey. "Finish the piece with a sweet idea like honey," Berlioz exclaimed. And this is what Leonard Bernstein thought the piece should sound like.
Oh, honey, oh, honey, oh, honey, oh, honey.
Could harmonize joyfully would be a grand way to welcome the lamb, but the word honey was not right for the beauty of a newborn. Having evaded the buzzing bees, the exhausted composer rested under a shady tree. He knew that the piece needed a central closing theme. How about hallelujah? Bela barked out. Perfect, meowed Benjamin. As the sun was setting, the musician's imagination was awakened. It was time to head back to his keyboard and finish the composition. With incredible speed and purpose, he added brilliant strings, simple dance rhythms, and last but not least, the chorus, Hallelujah. Gleeful harmony filled with the barn when the friends gathered to perform McCandle's masterpiece in celebration of Robert and Clara's newborn. The lamb would be called Emmanuel. Hallelujah. Please join all of McCandle's barnyard friends in this final song. For singing, my dad for videography, and stay inside these next few weeks and get lots of practice in.